President Yoweri Museveni this morning appointed new ambassadors and deployed others to new diplomatic missions. Among its newly created missions are Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia, Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates, Algiers in Algeria, Guangzhou in China, Ottawa in the USA, Canberra in Australia, and Tehran in Iran. Some of the 14 appointees are not career diplomats, but politicians who lost in parliamentary elections.
If you send a politician, a failed politician at that, to a country, for instance, you know, China, which is one of the power center, global power centers, how is that politician able to articulate fundamental principles within the foreign policy of your country to the benefit of your country, apart from really doing politics?
Ambassador to a country like China is a cabinet level appointment. An ambassador to New York, to the UN, is cabinet level appointment. And I think if we want to build and strengthen our institution, if you are going to deal with a first world country, a country which is the second most powerful in economic terms, why would you not send a person of Kiyonga's stature to do for you, to take, first of all, to take his status there, his stature there, and do for you a good job?
But the government spokesperson Ofwono Opondo accuses career diplomats of being incompetent. He also blames them for failing to attract investments and articulating Uganda's foreign policy.
I think the decision is born out of the fact that the career diplomats who have been heading missions haven't been sensitive to the economic needs of the country. Career diplomats have been heading these missions, but they have not marketed Uganda appropriately, effectively, as they should have been. And what are those needs? Telling the world, telling where they are representing Uganda, that Uganda is ripe for foreign investment.
Heads of missions, they should be able to look at the people who have expertise, who have the knowledge, who have the experience in diplomatic work. You know, it takes about 18 years through the civil service for one to rise to the level of ambassador. There is a reason as to why it takes 18 years.
Many of those on the list are those I would call diplomats by default.
Agara Olua, who was in Turkey, in Ankara, has done a great job since he went there about 5 years ago. For the first time in the history of Uganda, we have Turkish investors in Uganda.
It boils down to the fact that, are these people able to articulate our policies, our foreign policy? Are they able to broaden our market? Are they able to foster good understanding and harmony between Uganda and those countries where they have been posted?
Among its key appointments is Mohammed Kezaala, the party chairperson of the Democratic Party. Kezaala, who spoke to NTV soon after news started trickling in about his appointment, says he will first consult his party before he accepts the role.
I've been holding very sensitive positions in the party. So naturally, I have to brief the party president of this development, and after which I'll get back to the press and communicate to the country.
But his party president, Norbert Mao, had this to say.
The NRM is a predator. The NRM is trying to choke the life out of competing political parties. Yoweri Museveni is a shameless poacher. He's an incorrigible political poacher. He does not like to invest in building leaders, but he waits for leaders that have been built by other parties.
Mao says if Kezaala takes up the job, he will automatically step down from the party position.
That means he will become a civil servant. Automatically, that will require him to relinquish the position of leadership.
A meeting of the DP party will be convened tomorrow to discuss Kezaala's appointment. Another surprising appointment is that of King of Busoga, William Gabula Nadiope. Gabula has been appointed ambassador with special duties in the office of the president.
I've been trying to reflect on the appointment of the king of Busoga. And for me, according to the laws of Uganda, there is still a challenge. And there is a clear mark with regard to how far cultural and traditional leaders can go with respect to political maneuvers.
If it so pleases him and he accepts to work, it will be of a great benefit, not only to the Busoga, but to the Ugandans. Because as you know, gone are the days when kings could just sleep in their palaces, could just sit and wait for things to be brought by their subjects, goats, cows, whatever.
The onus is really on him to either leave the other one or take this one.
That the appointment of the Kyabazinga is unfortunate, it is unconstitutional, and it's not called for now.
Jingo Francis, NTV, Weekend Edition.